First thing I want to say is the mayor was here, Mayor Baker. He had to had another event. He wanted me to say that he's sorry he had to leave early, and that he, well, he read my resolution. He said he liked it, so that's a good thing that the mayor likes something. And so I want to give this resolution here. It was introduced by myself, Councilman Jay Street, and Councilman Penrose Hollins. And it's recognizing the Friends of the Port and African American Maritime Society. It starts off as, whereas the late President Woodrow P. Wilson stated, "We cannot be separated in interest or divided in purpose. And whereas the mission of the Friends of the Port is to ensure the political, educational, social, economic equality of rights for all people and to eliminate racial discrimination in the maritime community. And whereas the Friends of the Port is instrumental in navigating the course, communicating in both adults and our children the role of the maritime community and our African American community, and the contributions made by declaring dedicated individuals who have helped preserve this important part of our culture. And whereas a special appreciation to Richard Mouse Smith," yes, Mouse, I threw Mouse in there, I knew you wouldn't just accept Richard Smith, "for being the driving force conceptualizing and establishing the Friends of the Port. And whereas the Friends of the Port represent the spirit and pride that makes Newcastle County a great place to call home. Now, wherefore, be it resolved that the Council, the County Council of Newcastle County, that we ask all our fellow citizens to join us in recognizing the Friends of the Port and assisting them in enhancing the quality of life for the people associated with our maritime community." And I'd just like to add that many people don't understand the port. There are some really good people that work there. They're in good jobs. They make a pretty good wage. And that helps them go back into the community and helps our community grow. We had a situation where a resolution came before us for dredging. Council supported that to try to make sure we keep the jobs here. Personally, I believe the port's one of the real gems of Delaware, especially in Newcastle County. And we need to do everything we can to make it grow. And I think it's one of the places that in the future you're going to see lots of growth. So I'm happy to be here tonight. When Mouse asked me, I dropped everything. I said I'd be here. Mouse is running around cutting cake or something. I don't know what he's doing. But Mouse, I have some things that you wished for our guests from afar, and I'll leave them with you.
Good evening. It's my honor to share in presenting to you this evening and presenting an award to Councilwoman Blackwell. My dad was a member of the port and a union man, so I know what it means to work and fight for the rights of people, and I understand what labor means to us. So it's an honor for me to present this to you. Councilwoman Janie Blackwell is a graduate of Cheney University, where she received a Bachelor of Science degree in education. And she's a graduate of St. Joseph University, where she received her master's degree. Sounds like someone likes St. Joseph. We have a son there, so I like it too. Councilwoman Blackwell began her political career by serving as a special assistant to the governor assigned to the Pennsylvania Legislative Black Caucus in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. She resigned with her husband, then State Representative Lucian E. Blackwell, when he ran for and was elected to city council. That's a port for your husband. In addition to serving as delegate to the National Convention for the last four presidential elections, she served as administrative assistant to Lucian Blackwell campaigns for mayor, four for city council, and three for the U.S. Congress. She also served in the capacity during his 15-year term in city council before succeeding him. Since taking office in 1992, Councilwoman Blackwell has emerged as a strong contender and power broker in the local political arena. Elected among her peers as majority leader in 2000, Councilwoman Blackwell is a behind-the-scenes consensus builder and problem solver, a stellar politician who understands the making of solid policy. Councilwoman Blackwell has introduced significant legislation during her four council terms. In addition to her role as majority leader from 2000 to 2008, Blackwell is also chair of the Education Committee and the chair of the Committee on Housing, Neighborhood Development, and Homeless. She is vice chair of the Finance Committee and member of the Committee of the Whole, Committee on Transportation and Public Utilities, and the Committee to Ethics. Councilwoman Blackwell is also a co-founder and commissioner on the Mayor's Commission on African and Caribbean Immigrant Affairs. Councilwoman Blackwell has made a lifelong commitment to move her community forward and will always work to foster an end to homelessness, neighborhood blight, and poor public education through using the tools of public policy, legislation, and public involvement. Her overall vision is to improve her constituents' quality of life, regardless of race, class, gender, or socioeconomic status. She continues to believe that there is a solution to every problem, and that when we work together, everybody wins. Thank you so much. Again, as I said, it is my pleasure and my honor to present this award. You know, I think I understand my father actually was on the battlefield with your husband. Oscar Jones was my, oh, I said that like everybody knows that. Oscar Jones was my father. And I know he was on the battlefield with your husband more than once. So that makes this doubly special for me. So I'm honored to present to Councilwoman Janie Blackwell for your family's outstanding work and contributions above and beyond to the longshoremen. Thank you. Friends of the Port, April 10th, 2010.
Is not this beautiful? Let me say again good evening and thank God for this honor and privilege. Congratulations to all the honorees, and I thought I was here to present a city council citation to Carl Helm. Little did I know I would be so honored. Let me say that coming in here and seeing maritime and an African-American Maritime Society is a miracle, because certainly in Philadelphia, we had one union that Lou belonged to, 1332. He started off on the waterfront shoveling iron ore and worked his way up to president. And let me tell you about how the waterfront and dealing with men and their issues doesn't train you. So he went from shoveling iron ore to being a member of the U.S. Congress. Tell me labor isn't important. Certainly you mentioned Skinny Wilson, and as has been said, we traveled all over the world. Those were some good old days. People knew who they were, knew what the mission was, and we battled, but we battled together. So it is certainly a pleasure to be here. Let me greet all elected officials, Honorable Ted Blunigan, certainly Judge Smith, a Common Police Court judge whose wife has received an award for her brother, State Senator Anthony Hardy Williams, Lynn Carter, our boxing judge, everybody at our table, relative to Kathy Sludge, Wadia Floyd, and all who are here. This is such a special, special night, and I am so honored that Lou would be remembered and our family for our contributions and our love for the Philadelphia waterfront and for labor everywhere. We are still the backbone of this country.
It's unfortunate that a friend of mine, a state senator from the state of Pennsylvania, Leanna Washington, she wanted to be here to accept this award and also to see all of you, to show her support for the state of Delaware, because the state of Delaware shows support for the state of Pennsylvania, because we're joined at the hip. We only have 95 between us. So on her behalf, Ms. Phyllis Pride will accept this acknowledgement. And I will read it. Presented to State Senator Leanna Washington in appreciation for your dedicated service to the tri-state community. Thank you, Friends of the Port, April 10th, 2010. Would you recognize Phyllis Pride, please?
Thank you. Good evening to everyone. I'm quite sure that Ms. Washington is very grateful for this, and thank you, Newcastle, Delaware, and also I'd like you to know I am a former resident of Delaware. I worked at the Wilmington Housing Authority. So thank you, and God bless you all.
I think I was probably called because I grew up in Philadelphia, and I knew Hardy Williams' father, and he was such an excellent basketball player, both Hardy Williams, the older Hardy Williams, as well as the younger Hardy Williams, who wasn't as good an athlete as the dad. But the guy that mentored most of us at that time was a guy by the name of Sam Evans. And he passed away, and he was 104 years of age. And he was known as the Dean of Black Politics in the city of Philadelphia. And he nurtured many of the black elected officials, as well as some of the white elected officials coming along at that time. But Hardy was the one that he would go to get advice in terms of what was happening in the General Assembly. And it's most certainly a pleasure for me to present this to the son, Hardy Williams Jr., because of the legacy of the dad. And knowing both of them, they represented the city of Philadelphia exceptionally well. And so on behalf of Friends of the Court and it's not the court, you guys aren't being indicted? Friends of the Port. That's an inside joke, so you know I go way back with the Port. But again, the Friends of the Port, that was a Freudian slip, so sorry about that. So on behalf of the Friends, as well as Mouse, who 5 minutes ago came and told me I needed to say something, Mickey Mouse, thank you very much.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you on behalf of my brother, Senator Anthony Hardy Williams, and my beloved father, passed away in January. We thank you for the
City of Philadelphia, City Council citation honoring Carlton Carl Helm. The Council of the City of Philadelphia is pleased and proud to honor Carlton Carl Helm on the occasion of his birthday. Whereas Carl Helm was born on April 9th and spent most of his adult life in the entertainment industry. He worked in marketing for local radio station WDAS before becoming an on-air personality. And whereas Carl, as we all call him, was the first all-night disc jockey at WDAS AM/FM. During this time, he was also engaged in recording background vocals for various artists, including Patti LaBelle, Dionne Warwick, Denise Williams, Grace Jones, Johnny Mathis, The Stylistics, Blue Magic, Joe Simon, Eddie Kendricks, and Teddy Pendergrass. Carl worked on major recording projects with some of the greatest songwriters and producers, including Bunny Sigler, Bobby Eli, and Phil Hurt. And whereas, Carl has seen some tremendous changes in our society. He has been a wonderful asset to our city of Philadelphia, and we are proud to call him one of our favorite citizens. Therefore, by virtue of this citation, the Council of the City of Philadelphia does hereby honor Carl Helm on the occasion of his birthday. We hope that this will be filled with the love of family and friends that he deserves so much, and we extend the sincere admiration and very best wishes of the entire City Council of Philadelphia Legislative Body. Again, for your birthday yesterday, Carl Helm, we say thank you. This was agreed to, signed by me, but agreed to every member of the Philadelphia City Council. So thank you again, and let me thank you for remembering Lucian Blackwell and labor.
I've been involved in Philadelphia politics since 1963 when I got to WDAS. I have a lot of heroes. One person comes to mind immediately, and that's Cecil Moore, who was an organizer. And can I get a hand for Cecil Moore? You know, in Philadelphia, I guess all inner cities, a lot has changed since I was on the radio. We used to give flowers to those who helped people while they were walking around with us. And even after they passed away and we went to the gravesite, they were forgotten. I will never be able to forget the influence of Cecil Moore on my life, the influence of Georgia Woods on my life, the utter amazement of the knowledge of Sam Evans. I will never be able to forget the distinct effect that Lucian Blackwell had on my life, and Skinny. Y'all know Skinny? That worked at the port down here. He was a union representative at the port. These are people I met growing up. I was 21, 22, 23 years old, and just absorbing a lot of knowledge. They passed it on to me. And I just have to realize and recognize that these people, if it was not for these people, including today, Janie Blackwell is one of my heroes. I love her to death. I overlove Janie Blackwell, if you can overlove a person, because she gives so much of her soul. She gives when people stop giving, she don't go to sleep. She gives. Her phones are always ringing off the hook. And Leanna Washington and Cherelle Parker are the same kind of people. I think of Dave Richardson, Dwight Evans. Cherelle Parker is a product of Dwight Evans and Leanna Washington. She's young and upcoming with a lot of spirit to do a lot for her community. And we need community activists, all right? We need people that will go in the community and do things for the people that they say they're gonna do for them. And these people do things for people. They just don't get recognized, and that's why we're doing it. So on behalf of State Representative Cherelle Parker, I accept this award for her. And it reads, in appreciation for your dedicated service to the tri-state community. Thank you, friends of the port. Would you give her a nice round of applause? Thank you.
In a recent phone conversation, you made me aware that my mentor, the late William Hicks Anderson, was also a former associate of yours. Hicks was one of our most prominent community activists, and I know you and Hicks had a lot in common as it relates to the African-American community. Hicks was active in the community and led demonstrations and served as a change agent. On the other hand, you were an entertainer, DJ, and activist in your own right. The fact is, WDAS and now the famous Carl Helm events serve not only as entertainment, but a source of information, education, and motivation to do the positive thing for the betterment of the African-American community. In that regard, you did it your way, and our community has benefited immensely from your work. I just wanted to say thank you for what you have done, continue to do, and for tonight's purposes, happy belated birthday to you as a well-established pioneer in entertainment and civil rights. Thank you very much.
Let me take a deep breath. Wow. Let me start by saying this. When Richard and I have been working on a project to help people for 15 years. Our whole motive was to, we were in a position to do things for other people. We were never concerned about ourselves. I always use my microphone to help people. At this point in my life, I could be a very, very rich man, but a very, very sad person. And I didn't choose that life. I had a lot of opportunities to be where the stars are. I've been around the stars. My first job was shining shoes. And that's the God's truth. I shine shoes because my mom worked three jobs, and my sister will attest to that. Lillian, right there. I had to go to work, you know? And there were helping hands that helped me to go to higher levels. All I had to do was pay attention to the advice that they were giving me. And by, the grace of God, I listened. And we continue on this journey. To be celebrated, I didn't want a party. But Richard said, I want to give you a party. I don't want no party. Let's do something for somebody else. So this is what we're doing. This part is for y'all. We want you to leave this building tonight, think about somebody you could help to go to the next level. If it means filling out your census, do it. If it means voting in the next election, do it. Put the proper person in place that will help you and the people that will be behind you, your kids, your grandkids. You understand what I'm saying? And that's my whole thing. And that's why I stand here. Janie, I love you. Jay, Hicks was my, he introduced me to Delaware back in 1964. Whew, I was 22 years of age. We did the Baynard Field out here. We did a concert at Baynard Field. Whew. And since that time, I've done concerts in Asheville, North Carolina, Greensboro, Winston-Salem, Asheville, and Charlotte with Georgia Woods. We booked Earth, Wind, and Fire, the whole nine yards. But I still remain focused, and I still am focused on helping people. I'm just pleased that people feel the same way that I do. I'm not trying to change you. You need to change yourself. Be a better person. Love yourself. If there's something inside of you that doesn't fit, don't force it. Change it. Change it. Because you can help somebody. If I can help somebody as I pass along. You know that song? If I can cheer somebody with a word or song. If I can tell somebody that they're traveling wrong, then my living will not be in vain. Thank you very much.
Classy, Cousin Leah, and Sister Bertha, what's your name, Dad? And we're enjoying ourselves at the Friends of the Port. Brother Chris right here, and we will be back next year.
I have a tribute here for you, and it's a whole lot of whereases in it. I'm not going to read it. Nobody's going to try to outword Smith the Mayor. Here's the bottom line for me. Let's go all the way back. Let's go back when he called himself being a 13th Street Stomper. And come up on the hill talking to a yang, and then, you know, that's how we got started. But what happened was, we called ourselves being little gangsters and all that. God by the name Hicks Anderson came along and said, oh, no, y'all gonna do something else. And he made community activists. He developed us, a lot of people right here, not just me and Mouse, that Hicks personally trained. And, you know, Hicks, Mouse had a lot to do with putting out the fires that got started in the 60s, and he never stopped doing that community work. He worked with police agencies, he worked with U.S. Marshal's Office. And in the 90s, I had a kid who was up for expulsion in Brandywine School District. I used Mouse as a witness, and he was my expert in street community youth work, and the hearing officer certified him that way. But what a lot of people don't know about Mouse is he's probably the most generous, giving person that I know. It's enough for him to walk in the center and see a kid say, take care of Christmas. Take care of his birthday. Kid gets a good report card, he takes the kid. He sponsors entire families at Christmas time. So I just want to say he's a very special, special person to me. And happy birthday, Mouse. And, you know, I didn't make that brick turn the corner. You
Why did you turn the corner and look back? I don't understand that.
But as far as Anna is concerned, I remember what we wrote, and the bottom line is Anna has been an employee in Newcastle County in the revenue division for almost 30 years. Mouse said 29 and a half years. I rounded out and made it 30. And at the end of the day, she's established herself as an outstanding mother, family person, and somebody who gets up every day and takes care of family, and that's an exemplary person. And April has produced a lot of special people, and she is one of those very, very special people. And anybody had to grow up with Mouse and come through and work 30 years later is a real special person. So happy birthday to you.
It's been a pleasure for me to stand here and be able to introduce this brother to you. If a son is not like a father, then Richard is not like his father. His father has left his footprints in labor, very active in labor, and Richard has followed in his footsteps, and he's very involved in labor, always to remind us of where we come from. There's a whole lot of us that forget our background and forget where we come from. And if it had not been for labor, a whole lot of us wouldn't be here and wouldn't have the jobs we had and be able to afford what we afford. Matter of fact, labor was so good, we forgot who we were. We were taking vacations and having two cars and good health care and all those good things that labor provided and sending our children to college to become lawyers and doctors. And we forgot where we come from. So we're glad that we have friends like Richard who is quick to remind us that we're still labor. Union is not a word to be ashamed of. It's a word to stand proud for. And believe me, Richard stands proud in the AFL-CIO on the behalf of labor, but also on the behalf of African Americans in labor. Like we helped build this country, we also built the labor movement. And so we're glad that we have brothers such as Richard still in the labor movement to help promote us in the labor movement and they make sure that the labor movement continues to move forward. The report of our demise has been greatly exaggerated. We're not dead. We are yet alive. We're still kicking. We're still fighting. We helped fight for health care. We got it. We're going to continue to fight for jobs. We're going to get employee free choice. And there's a couple other things that we're going to do. So we're still around. We haven't went anywhere. And as long as we have people like Richard Womack out there on the front line fighting for us, we'll continue to be a force in this country. So Richard, thank you for all that you do. And thank you for being in the labor movement and keeping the labor movement strong. This says in appreciation for your dedicated service to the Tri-County community. Let me also say, Richard, he just got elected commissioner in Sharon Hill. All right. Now, see, a lot of y'all don't know about Sharon Hill. Yeah. Those of you who have ever been to Sharon Hill know about Sharon Hill and the firehouse. Yeah. Back in the day. Back in the day. So he's just got elected commissioner out in Sharon Hill, and we're so proud of him, Richard Womack.
Let everybody say amen.
Amen.
I thank you, Sam, very much for the introduction. I'm sorry I left my wallet at home, so I have to IOU tonight. But nevertheless, I want to thank Mouse, who's a very good friend, a very good supporter of mine. When I met Mouse is because him and I was working on a campaign together. And if you know Mouse, he does not give up. He is very forceful, he's a go-getter, and he's one that will call me every night, sometimes 7-8 times a day. But nevertheless, Mouse, I love you, and I adore you as a friend. And call anybody a friend, but I'm here today to tell you, you are a friend, and you are my friend. I thank you. Also, I want to thank everyone in this room for this award. I was only able to achieve my goals on account of everyone in this room. I thank you, and I want to say to you, you continue the great work that you do that we can have more young people to stand up here in this position. Thank you, and have a good night.
I started at the Port of Wilmington in 1992. And I remember you greeting me as a young guy when I was still wet behind the ears a little bit. But you always told me to keep my head up because things will always be all right, whether it's down a port or anywhere else in life. So on behalf of the Friends of the Port and for your service, not just to the port, but outside of the community, your efforts everywhere, the Friends of the Port is dedicating this plaque to you. And the plaque says, Friends of the Port, 2009-2010, Dock Worker of the Year Award, presented to Mr. Dwight Anderson. In recognition of your outstanding service and hard work in the port community, April 10th, 2010. We love you.
First of all, I'd like to say thank you. Didn't know the people of the port care about me that much. Richard, oof. We want to kill each other sometime. But he was going through a whole lot. I mean, it seemed like people were stabbing knives in his back. But he came through it all. I'm glad. Richard, thank you. The reason why I work on the court right now is because of Richard Smith.
There was many days when I rode around with Dwight and Ricky Smith. And anybody who can deal with Ricky Smith, I mean, Dwight took the brunt of the storm because Mousy was, I don't even want to say it, terrible. And that's a true friend, a real true friend, because if it was me, I'd tell him where to go at.
To everybody that came today and to the people at the port, I just want to say thank you for inviting me. This is a very nice affair. I've known Mouse ever since I used to live on 11th Street, and that was years and years and years ago. He's always been Mouse, and he's always been a good friend. This afternoon, when I filled out his birthday card, I wanted to say something. And one of the things I said, happy birthday to one of the nicest guys that I know. God bless you, God keep you in his grace and in his mercy. Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
It's a great event, and I'm really thankful to be here.
Look at that picture. How long ago was that, Mom? You was about what? 20. But anyway, in my 40 plus years, and I don't want to let y'all know how old my mom is, but in my 40 plus years, I've come to do a lot of things in my life, such as A. Philip Randolph, Coalition of Black Trade Unions, and now NAACP, and now union president. Wait a minute, the applause don't go to me. I'm not finished yet. But anyway, in that time, I've been advised and guided by certain individuals. And one in particular is so ambitious that he'll give you advice, but he wants that advice to be used the way he gives it.
So, you know, you don't have a voice, you know. He's been my Jedi Knight throughout my entire life. My entire life, and this is very, very special to me. I mean, I can go on and give him a whole lot of accolades and say this and say that about him, but the most important aspect of our relationship is that I love him, and I love him dearly. And that's my uncle, Rich Mouse Smith. To the man that made this all possible tonight, Mr. Richard Smith. And this plaque is from the Friends of the Port. And it reads as such: Special Recognition Award presented to Richard Smith Mouse in appreciation for outstanding leadership, commitment, and service to the community. Friends of the Port. This is our Director of Human Resources at the Port of Wilmington.
My name is Sylvia Floyd Kennard. And I'd just like to say that I'm really glad to be here tonight. And I recall the first few days that I was here at the Port of Wilmington, coming from the Port of Baltimore. I have to say that Mousie was very helpful to me. He tried to introduce me to those people that he felt would help me through my tenure at the port. And I really appreciate that, because he was very supportive, and being the only female, the only black on the board of directors for the port, I really appreciate his support that he gave to me. And, you know, he really tried to guide me to those people that would perhaps help me in doing the things that I have to do. And I really appreciate that, and I'm really glad that I know him, because he really tries to be as supportive as possible, and you can't ask for a better friend. So I appreciate being here, and I'm glad that he invited me, and I'm glad that I'm here. So thank you so much, Richard.
A whole lot of father figures on this stage tonight. I have a lot of father figures that groomed me down the port. I have a lot of father figures on this stage that done helped me and helped me strive to be the kind of person that I am today. But Richard, I really, really wanted to tell you that I love you. I love you because of what you've done taught me, what you've done for me, and we done had some battles. I mean, I'm gonna take you behind on paper rolls and this get ready to go down. And you made me cry. Made me cry.
I'm gonna tell nobody that.
That's all right. Because they were tears of joy, and it also brought me to be a better man. It taught me how to be a man in a sense that, you know, we can get through anything down the port, and even as a people today, all we have to do is just stick together. And that's one thing that we really, really need to admonish to ourselves, is to really, really, really stick together. Again, I love you.
Woo! Lord, have mercy.
I ain't never seen so many awards given in one night. Oh my God. You know, I was over there, almost went to sleep. You know what I'm saying? But when they pay you first, you can't walk out. You know what I'm saying? But I thought about it, because there is a door back there.
There's so much going on, it's crazy. Try